Blood is quite juicy and it's also fun. So, I'm going to teach you how to add it to your Godot game. So, here we are in the Godot editor. You wanted to add some blood in your game. Here is our goal. This boil here needs to be deleted and emit blood particles. Okay, so how can we do it? Let's get to the dude scene and see the code. Every frame, the system checks if I have pressed enter, and if I did, it calls blowup method. And currently blowup is just Q3, so the dude is just being deleted, like that. Boom, it's deleted. But before we start making the particles themselves, we'll write the code for the dude that will emit particles. First of all, add the export variable of type packed scene. It will contain our blood scene. And why did I use export variables? Because sometimes you might want to have red blood for one enemy, green blood for another, and maybe blue for someone else. And it's even possible that these bloods will be three different scenes with maybe three different parameters. But the algorithm that creates the particles are the same. That's why it's quite convenient to use export variables. Back to the code. In the blowup method, I have added code that creates the particles. First, it checks whether we have something in blood, because by default it's null, so there is nothing to create and we'll get an error. But if it is something and we can create it, then we instantiate it, we add it to the tree, and we set the position of the particles to the position of the dude, and then the dude is being deleted. And so now we can start working on the particles themselves. Create a new node. I'm going to use CPU particles 2D. In fact, there is no big difference between the two, but of course, if you just prefer particles 2D, you can use it. Rename it, save it, and now let's start playing with settings. Set the amount to 32, lifetime, for now it will be 1, explosiveness to 1, drawing, let's set the texture right away, direction, set the spread to 180, gravity, turn it off, initial velocity, I'll set it to 100, linear acceleration to minus 50, velocity randomness 0.95, 100 damping, scale 0.5. Now, come back to time, set the lifetime to 5 seconds, one shot to on, and change the color to red. Now, as you can see, since we have set one shot to true, after it has been emitted, emitting value is off. So, now we need to make sure that we always have the particles emitting when they are spawned. Create a new script for the particles, and in the script write this, and here we go. Now, we can come back to our dude scene, set the blood particles to blood particles scene, and we can check how it's working. Boom! The problem is, we still have the blood particles as an object, even though it can no longer be rendered. Therefore, we need to delete the blood particles after they have been emitted. Create timer, rename it to delete timer, set one shot and auto start to on, and wait time, let's set it to 5. Now, connect the timeout signal of the timer to blood particle script and write Q3. And boom, here it's working. The particles are created. The particles are deleted. And here, we can see that there is no longer useless objects here. And well, we could end the video here. But maybe you want to add some fanciness in your game. We can make the blood fade after a certain period of time, and after it fades out, it will be deleted. In order to do that, rename the delete timer to fade timer. Tweak the wait time as you wish. connect the timeout signal of the fade timer. There is not much reason to create another method because the timeout is already connected to only timer timeout method, but I don't want to get confused later down the road. So I make sure my signals names correspond to their methods. Add the variable is fading, and in the onFadeTimerTimeout method, add this line. Create physics process function, check whether the blood is fading, and if it does, decrease the alpha. In order to delete blood when it fade out, write this. You can tweak the values and change, but for me I found that I like 0.1 the best. And so, here we have our blood. Works quite nicely. You still may tweak some stuff in the blood settings and see what works best for you, but for this video, that's it. I hope it was useful, and if you liked the video, don't forget to hit that like button, share and subscribe. See you next time!